and kind of see why you're doing this or your views. Or
I agree.
And you have to. Like, you have to have conversations with people that you
can't talk to somebody
that you don't connect with.
Who does not want to have that conversation. Yeah. It's beating a dead horse. I don't want to keep explaining to people why we're upset and why people are mad. Like, I'm not finna keep doing that shit. My dad a cop. I got black brothers. Like, I'm not doing that shit. This shit is exhausting.
But then it's like, if we don't, then what?
Nigga, the shit gonna
keep getting crazy. Yeah, it's just gonna keep getting crazier and crazier.
It's like being a dead horse, like she said. Yeah. Nothing's gonna change.
Keep repeating myself.
You can keep talking to your blue in the face, but
so there's no. Once again, so what's the resolution? How do you fix it?
Ain't no resolution.
This shit is crazy.
Tell you now, if I die now, burn this motherfucker to the ground. I don't want no peaceful protest. Don't. We shall overcome none of that shit. Burn this bitch down. Oh, the LA Sparks. They walked out. They walked back to the locker room and skipped the national anthem.
So they didn't even come out?
No, they came out. They walked back out. They left the floor. That was Sunday. Shout out to the WNBA. They don't get enough respect. Girls be out here dunking on niggas.
Do they?
I don't know shit. I don't watch, you know.
All right, let's get on a little
music.
We could, or yeah, we could touch music.
There's a lot of music.
A lot of people dropped.
Yes.
CJ, you want to start?
Start with Tank.
Start with Tank.
I
want to just get this out the way, or what you want? Well, go ahead.
You can't even go back to that conversation.
Okay, all right.
I never
Please don't.
Go ahead.
I never discredited Tank. I love Tank. He's one of my favorites, and you know that. So I love the album. Nita, on the other hand, she's.
I mean, I love Tank, but yeah. I wasn't moved.
No, I couldn't.
It's a few tracks. Yeah. I was like,
it was cool.
Then I was like, you could have kept that.
Yeah, yeah.
My favorite song is "You Belong to Me."
Yeah, but other no.
It was straight though. I agree with y'all. It was just
I liked it.
I did. Yeah, yeah.
So what would you get out of a 5?
At 3 points.
Yeah, I was about to say I'll give it 3.5.
I'll give it 4.
3.5, 4-ish.
You can keep that point touching 5, it. But 3.5.
Okay.
Yeah. B minus.
Frank Ocean dropped a new song.
Did he?
It's called Provider.
Told you, bro. Oh, he can't be my boyfriend.
Is it? No, it's not.
I've been heard that.
Did he actually drop it on iTunes?
Yes, I have it on my iTunes.
Well, see, I just got the notification on Friday.
Yeah.
CJ, what is going on with you and music?
Slacking, man. What's up?
I know. That's the second one now, right?
That's the second time.
Well, you didn't even know he dropped it, so hold up now.
But think about that anyway, because I've deleted all of Frank Ocean off of my iTunes because we broke up.
Right, I understand that. But I just got the notification, so to me, it was a new song. Okay.
Oh, it doesn't tell you when I added it, but yeah.
Well, okay, I like it. Yeah. Nevertheless, I like it. Okay, so I told you this. Eric Bellinger, it's not really new, but it is a new album for President term.
So it's all
two.
Acoustic.
It's all acoustic, right.
But he got the regular one, though.
Yeah, he has the regular one, but the regular one is old.
Yeah. I love
but
Eric
he
Bellinger.
Did a new one that dropped Friday, but all the songs are acoustic, I actually like it.
Right.
Did you listen to it?
Yeah, I like Air
Bellinger.
I know you do, but I'm saying, but did you listen to
listen
the acoustic?
The acoustic one, yeah.
I think it was nice.
Yeah. He's very talented, man. He don't really get the credit that he deserves.
Yeah, he's definitely underrated. We got to talk about the song.
It's funny because he probably wrote a lot of these songs.
He wrote a lot of songs for Chris Brown, too. Right,
he did a lot of songs
for Chris Brown. A lot of songs for Chris Brown. Of course, the song that Beyonce did.
Yeah, what I don't even know the artist's name. I don't want to be crazy.
I can't say it. I don't want to say it. Oh, J Balvin. And Willie William.
It's called Niente.
Niente.
So she...
And all the song is for the hurricane victims in Puerto Rico.
So it's going all the proceeds are going to go to Puerto Rico. Shout out to B.
And she did her thing in English and in Spanish on the song.
Nah, she did kill it, though.
So I love it. And the beat is dope. Yeah. It's definitely a club song.
That song is fire.
Yeah, yeah.
Definitely fire.
Brian McKnight dropped a new album.
I didn't listen.
One Last Cry.
Right, called Genesis.
You listen to it?
I haven't listened to the whole thing yet, but from the first 4 tracks I heard, I actually like it, but I still need old Brian McKnight. You can tell his voice, but you know.
Yeah. I don't know, I kind of love Brian McKnight back in the...
Brian McKnight is very underrated, something? For
what
one.
What did he say? Whatever song he was doing that parody for, that's when Brian McKnight lost me. What was it? That pussy song he was talking about? I was like, what? Yeah. Whoa.
He's definitely underrated. I always felt like he was underrated.
I don't feel like Brian McKnight was ever underrated.
I don't think he got the credit that he deserved.
You don't think so?
No.
I don't know, man.
You think
I mean, because
so?
When he was out, I mean, yeah, it was a lot of other, you know what I mean?
Artists
that was out, yeah. So, you know, that's kind of like... if I put it in sports terms, I mean, that's like KD, Steph, LeBron, Melo. It's like pick one. They're still good, but it's like one gets outshined by, you know, somebody else that's probably a little bit better. But, you know, he's still good. But
okay. Elijah Blake know you said you never.
No, I heard of him.
Yeah, but
I
didn't hear
it. He dropped a new album.
I didn't hear it.
It's actually really good.
What's it called?
Talk about this Tamar though.
Oh, that too.
But what's his album called?
Elijah Blake.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, it's called Autoology.
Autoology. Oh, okay.
It's actually really dope.
To it.
Yeah, it's real dope. You'll like it.
And we'll revisit this conversation. We'll park.
I don't know if you listen to a guy named Khalil.
Khalil.
Yeah,
that's the one that did. What was that song that he?
Oh God! He dropped a new album though.
Fuck man!
It's called Prove It All.
Okay.
The album is really good. It's only 13 tracks, but it's really good. Definitely like a chill mode type.
I'm thinking of Khalid. Wrong one. My bad.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
Location.
Yeah, Party but, next door.
Yeah. P&D. How do y'all feel about that?
I didn't like it.
I really think these are just throwaways for the album.
I do.
You know, he got the Club Atlantis coming.
I
kind of
feel
out.
Like.
It was a different.
I was gonna say the same thing. It's a different sound for me from Party Next Door. It didn't give me that original sound I'm used to hearing from them.
I think
these are just throwaways to me.
Like I said, it was only two tracks. So I agree with you. Two tracks.
Putting it out there to make you know.
I give it a toots.
I agree with you on that.
But I still listen to it.
Two for the two songs that I like.
Yeah, two for the two songs I like. Because it's like nine. What is it, like seven of them?
Seven.
Yeah.
It's what seven, right?
Yeah.
Fergie's album.
I didn't know it was out.
Yes. It actually was good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'll listen to it. I loved
Called
Fergie's
Double
first
Duchess.
Album.
It's actually really, really good. Okay. Let It See dropped the new album.
I did see that.
I need to listen to this Demi, though.
Demi Lovato?
Lovato.
Mm-hmm. My bad. Yes. So now we can talk about Bluebird of Happiness.
Tamar's album is super dope.
Please stop. Okay, so on my timeline, I can't talk about anyone else's timeline, but a lot of people were giving her slack for the album. I loved it. I think it's actually... I love it. I would say Calling All Hearts, then this, then Love and War. Love and War, to me, was more poppy. She didn't really give me that R&B that I know she can give me. Like, some of the tracks were on there. With R&B, yeah. But it was
Calling
more
All
like
Lovers
poppy.
Was my shit.
Calling All Lovers, yeah. That I would say that, then this album, then Love and War. In that order.
Yeah. I fuck with Tamar the long way. You ain't even got to skip a track.
Like, her shit. Ranges on this album were sick.
Yeah.
I haven't heard it, so I don't know.
Go listen to it.
Please listen to it.
I'll listen.
It's strictly straight R&B, though. I will say that. It's all R&B. Mm-hmm.
Which we need. I feel like it's just, you know, I won't say the downside, but I just feel like it's...
You don't get the R&B that you used to get from the 90s.
Yeah. So like, when you have a good artist, like,
so who
you know,
would give
CJ
you
like
a good 90s
like you just keep it.
R&B
I mean,
album.
Brandy still got, you know, it's just certain
she
artists.
She better drop this damn album.
Yeah, she's really pissing me. Now, she did a video. I don't know if you've seen it on her page. She did a full out new music video. It's her and Ray J, but Ray J's in the background, but the whole video is her.
Okay. I haven't seen it, but.
In the video. And then, you know, the song they previewed at her concert. But
she's playing with me.
Yeah, she really.
Wait, what was you saying?
Album.
What artist gives you what? 90s?
A good 90s, like a give me a, give me like a good 90s album.
A good 90s album?
Start with female.
Female. Good 90s album that was a female album. Faith.
Mm-hmm.
Faith Evans.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Which one?
Pick one.
Her first album, definitely.
The album where As Soon As I Get Home.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm rolling. Okay. Monica.
And
which one?
Shit.
After the Storm, I'm sorry. After the Storm for me is by far one of my favorite albums by her.
That is one of my, Hell, I mean,
Brandy.
Brandy, Never Say Never.
Yeah. Never Say Never or Full Moon. Like, which one do I go?
Full came out in 2000, didn't it?
I did. You're right. So, Never Say Never then. Another female, Tamia.
Yes.
The one I'm So Into You.
What was the one with Stranger in My Closet?
Stranger in My House. That came out in 2000.
Yeah. That came out in 2000.
All right.
Because it was on Now. That's what I call music.
Yeah. Tamia, definitely.
So that's what I mean. I mean,
that's for female. Yeah. And it's more, of course.
Male.
Avant. Hands down.
Avant, R. Kelly.
Avant and R. Kelly and Joe. I can't.
And Brian McKnight. See how you tried to slide him? See?
Yeah, definitely. John B. He was definitely a non. He was like kind of like a. I want to say one hit wonder, but he definitely could have been one.
His album kind of had joints on there.
It did, but everyone knew him for They Don't Know.
And Are You Still Down? Hell, Babyface.
Yes. Donnell Jones,
Where I Want to Be.
Oh my God, we forgot Toni Braxton. Jesus.
Oh, of course,
Christ.
Toni Braxton.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Of course. You got to give me some more for male R&B, though, because it was so many for the 90s.
You can roll with groups, too, like 112.
Yeah, Jagged Edge.
Jagged Edge, yeah.
Case.
Case.
Fucking hell, Next.
Oh, yeah. Next. Butter Love.
Yeah.
Their first two albums was lit, though.
Let's go back, though. It's like High Five and So For Real.
Yeah, okay. Yeah,
After Seven?
Yeah. After Seven, yeah, yeah. But So For Real definitely was 90s.
Yeah, that was 90s.
At High Five, too. The Kissing Game. I like The Kissing Game. Like, Tony Tone.
Mint Condition.
Yeah. Pretty Brown Eyes.
Yeah.
No, Mint Condition, period.
Mint Condition, period.
We don't get that music no more, man. Like, that's...
I need more, though.
I don't know, man.
I need more.
That's really, like, the golden era. Like, that's crazy. Like,
Jodeci was definitely 90s.
Yep.
Mary J. Blige, 90s.
Oh, yeah, that's another one. Yeah.
Mariah Carey, 90s. Mariah Carey then.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, you can Butterflies,
Mariah Miami. Carey now.
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah.
The Mariah Carey Stevie J wrote for.
Yeah. Right.
Black Street.
Yeah.
That right there. Yeah.
What group came out of Black Street? It was Aaron Hall, for one.
Aaron Hall.
Yeah, but there was
talking about like Public Announcement and Guy and all them niggas.
Yeah, but Black Street came out of they formed that group. Out of
Dave
like,
Hollister and Teddy Riley.
Yeah, okay. All right. That was trying to get the names.
Mm-hmm.
MC Hammer.
What? Michael Jackson. Well, he was 80s and 90s. Janet Jackson.
First of all, Michael Jackson is eternal.
Did he put on an album?
Whitney Houston.
I could have sworn I was on Apple Music and I seen the new Michael Jackson album.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah, I'm finna say that nigga had...
Yeah, he's still making music.
Prince.
Yeah, can't forget Prince.
You sure can't.
And I would not never forget Prince. Absolutely not.
So do y'all feel like R&B is like, not struggling, but it's like... Do we forget about it sometimes?
I don't think it's struggling, but if you listen to a lot of songs now, they're mimicking songs. And every song is a remake, technically.
So new,
but like, yeah. Jacquees, he did a song, Bad. He never paid homage to Avant.
Yeah.
Read My Mind. That exact lyrics came from that song. And he not once ever said nothing about him.
So what do you think, what new artists now do you think are going to have, do you think that's going to have like that longevity of R&B, just R&B, not like Drake, like switching back and forth?
Okay, I would have to say Chris Brown, even though Chris Brown has been out for
I mean, like, new artists. Everybody knows. Oh, like
a new minute.
Like you said, Jacquees. Or
a new artist is R&B.
Somebody like Black. I don't know if I listen to Black.
Of course. Yeah, I do. I don't know. I'd have to think about, like, a male R&B artist. Right? That's
or
like,
female, too. I mean, you could say, like, what, Jhené Aiko and...
But I want to...
Yeah,
you wouldn't put her in R&B?
I need, like, true R&B. I need ballads. I need ranges.
Like Seven?
Yeah.
Like Seven.
Seven Streeter. That's
what about Division?
Oh, yeah.
Division. I'm just talking strictly R&B.
Oh, Daily?
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, you running low, though.
Yeah. Daniel Caesar. He's coming up.
His album's
amazing. I even think that.
It's tough, man.
Rutami, I think he can. If
he's fine ass.
I think if he stays consistent.
He's not. He's nice.
Yeah.
He's got a fan.
If he stays, he's
a sleeper.
I was late on his music.
You definitely was. If he stays consistent. Tone Stitch.
Tone Stitch.
I actually seen him in concert. He actually opened up for August Alsina.
Her. What about her?
Oh, yeah. And him.
And him.
I want to know the connection between them two.
I don't think there's
no
connection. There's no connection. Yeah. I think he just heard her album and heard the album, but and like was just answering.
Are we classified as Shizzle with this?
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, she's not. Really,
she can sing.
Yeah, I mean, R&B wise.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
She definitely.
Okay.
You know who dropped? He's old, but you know who dropped the album? Sammy dropped the album.
No, Sammy's album's actually.
It actually
good.
Everything. Are you serious? No, it really is.
Seriously. Like,
we're all coming of age.
But before that, his EP was really good.
I did see that. All right.
Yeah,
I didn't click it.
It really is good.
I just looked at the cover art.
Like, really
Sammy,
is good. He has a song called
really
Tsunami.
Yeah.
It's definitely a sex song. That definitely would be on to the extreme pleasurable sex playlist.
Still ain't got that playlist yet. Just
you can you know now you can follow people on with the new update.
I gotta do all this.
No,
on what?
On Apple Music now you can hit like if I say,
oh that okay, yeah give me the notification and you can
then,
see what they listen to.
Then you
right?
can accept my like if I say I want to follow you,
yeah.
so you accept it, then you'll see what I'm currently listening to.
Yeah.
You can play it and you can download it.
That's tough.
Yeah. So like you go to your For You. And then it should just automatically see friends recommend it. And so now you can just click everyone that you want to follow and stuff like that. And it'll tell you.
How does
you,
it follow you, though? How does it know who's on Apple Music? It just goes by your contacts?
I think it does.
See? Apple violating my rights and my privacy. I done told you it only
show you like what the person's listening to.
Okay.
So like if I click
it say get started. Okay.
I'm gonna do that.
See, so like I listened to that song with Beyonce and Darren was listening to it. So it'll tell you, and then you can click on him.